Dad was playing the violin on the car dealer.
Yep.
Used to travel Sunday mornings down to South Arm, Possum Bay.
Holidays destinations.
Shack owners. Mm. Then on Sunday afternoon, they'd have a piano and violin, 2 shilling 20 cent trip on the boat, and there would be 200 to 300 people on that boat every Sunday. The queue would go half a mile to get on. And the American soldiers, or the American service, got on that vessel. Dad would come home for lunch, Sunday lunch, which was always a big meal, and Dad would bring 2 or 3
of the
servicemen
up
for lunch. And now, in payment for that, these soldiers used to give cartons of cigarettes to Mum and Dad, which both non-smokers was like manna from heaven, because they could sell those cigarettes to their friends for $2 a packet.
Well, 20 cents. So when did your mother start smoking?
Mum started in when she had a stroke in 1954.
Okay, that clarifies that.
Yeah.
But of course, tobacco was currency.
Oh yes, tobacco was currency.
Wonderful currency.
And these were very grateful, but they talked war, lots of war. They just come from New Guinea, Guadalcanal. They were MacArthur's troops. On reflection, they weren't that well educated, but they all seemed to appear to have plenty of money. I now know that they didn't have much money. But as kids, you'd see kids walking around Hobart begging cents and money and cigarettes from these soldiers. I can still see that. Mm. Hobart was absolutely full of soldiers and servicemen from the States. There was Australians were here on leave as well.
Mm.
And there were lots of brawls between the American and Australian forces. Lots of fights. Even when I went to work in the early 50s, beer was in short supply, was rationed. But the soldiers were given an hour during the day to go and... So people I worked with at the Commonwealth Bank used to shoot down to McLaren's Hotel and have a couple of beers because the beer was on.
Oh, if the beer's on for the soldiers.
That's right.
But normally the residents weren't able to advantage of that.
Take advantage.
I see.
Soldiers used to get a cigarette ration.
That's very interesting. Now, your perception was they had money, but of course they're on shore leave.
Yeah.
They have their pay and they have nothing. Well, let's face it, they could be killed the next time they see action.
That's right.
That they're not going to be saving their money, are they?
No.
And because they're on shore leave, I guess they're going to be throwing it around. Yeah. So the impression that you got that they had money.
But there was a saying that I learned very early in my life when they were here. Overpaid, oversexed, and over here. The American, that was basically how the Americans were treated.
And you also, most people erroneously refer to them as Yankees.
Yes.
Even though Yankees Even is though a term.
Yankee were named the Northern Americans as against the South. Well, the Southerners, of course. But a lot of them did have Southern twangs too. So, and there were Negroes. And I'd never seen a Negro. There were Negroes, millions of Negroes. And you see the MPs in the street, they were tough with their sticks and so forth. But it had very big impact.